Salt Shaker friends, Casey here. Welcome to NXTGEN Live. Today, we're going to have an exciting Bible story. But before that, I want you guys to leave your suggestions, comments, and use hashtag NXTGEN Live, hashtag NXTGEN Salt Shakers. Now, who's ready to listen to the Bible story? Are your eyes, ears, and hearts ready? Are you ready? Count down with me. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hi kids, my name is Teacher Maybelle and this is my son, Gavin.
Hi.
So it's time again for our
Bible story.
So Gavin, do you remember what our lesson was last week?
It was about loving our neighbor.
And who is our neighbor?
Anyone and everyone we meet, even the people who don't like us.
Even the people who don't like us? Oh wow, so that includes people who may have already hurt us before, right? That's hard. Well, there is someone that I know who loved everybody, even the people who didn't want to believe in him, who made fun of him, shouted at him, hurt him, and even tried to kill him, and did kill him by nailing him on the cross. Do you know who that is?
Jesus!
That's right, it's Jesus. And Jesus says that we are to love everyone in the same way that he loves us. Now, last week, we talked about showing our love to our neighbor by helping them. This week, we're going to learn more about what it means to love other people in the same way that Jesus loved us. But we need to make sure first that we're ready for our story. Are you ready, Gavin?
Yep.
Are you guys ready? So if you're ready, show us by stretching your hands up. Stretch as high as you can. Ah, try to reach as far as you can. And put your hands back down on your laps. And here we are. We're ready.
Yep.
Let's go. So our story today is from Matthew 18, verses 21 to 35. It begins with Peter asking Jesus a question.
Lord, how many times should I forgive my brother who sins against me? Up to 7 times?
Not up to 7 times, Peter, but up to 70 times 7 times.
490 times?
It's just an expression, Gavin. Oh. What Jesus really means is that we should keep on forgiving again and again and again.
And again and again and again and again.
Okay, kids. I think you get what Jesus means. Now let me ask you, have you ever been hurt by somebody before? Maybe there was a time when a friend said something really mean to you, or maybe a brother or a sister who was being unfair when you were playing a game, or maybe somebody played a really nasty trick on you. How did you feel at that time? Did you feel sad? Did you feel disappointed, hurt? Or maybe you felt angry? Take a look at the different feelings in the picture here. Could you point to the picture that best describes how you felt at that moment? Thank you for your honesty, kids. Some of you said you were feeling sad at that moment. Some of you felt angry or disappointed. Well, whatever it is, I'm pretty sure it wasn't a nice feeling, was it?
Yeah.
And when we feel sad or angry, it can be so hard to forgive, right? Well, how much more if we have to forgive that person again and again and again?
And again and again.
So, how are we going to follow Jesus' command to forgive those who hurt us? Jesus tells Peter and the other disciples a story, or what we call a parable, to help them understand the lesson better.
The kingdom of God is like this parable. A king decides to collect all the money that all his slaves owed him. One slave owed the king 10,000 talents.
10,000 talents?
Okay, so the word talent here does not mean the same thing as being good at singing or dancing or drawing, okay? In Jesus' time, talent was a way of measuring a huge amount of money. In fact, for someone to be able to pay just one talent, he would need to be working for at least 15 years. So if we're talking about 10,000 talents, it would mean being enslaved for at least 150,000 years.
Nobody can do that.
Exactly. So you see, there was absolutely no way that this slave could pay the king back for what he owed, even if he worked for it all his life. Now let's see how the king responds in this story.
Since the slave could not pay back all that he owed, the king commanded that this slave, along with his wife and all his children and all the things he owned, to be sold to pay for all the money he owed. But when the slave heard this, he fell to the ground and begged the king,
"Have patience with me. Please give me time, and I will pay you back for everything."
Then the king was filled with pity for this slave. He let him go and forgave him for all the money that he was supposed to pay him.
So let me ask you, Gavin, what was the slave begging the king to do?
To give him time to pay back everything.
But could he really pay everything back, all the 10,000 talents?
No.
So did the king give him time to pay everything back?
No, but he forgave everything the slave owed.
Wow. So does he have to pay anything back?
No.
Amazing. What the king did was so much more than what the slave asked for. He freed the slave from having to pay back anything. Now, if you were this slave who was forgiven, how would you feel? Can you point to the picture that shows us how you might feel? Okay. Now, let's see how this slave responded to the forgiveness that the king gave him.
But when that servant went out and left the king, he found a fellow slave who owed him 100 denarii. He grabbed him by the throat and demanded that he pay back all that he owed right away. His fellow slave fell to the ground and pleaded with him, saying,
"Have patience with me. Please give me time and I will pay you back for everything."
But the slave did not care about his fellow slave. He had him put in prison until he could pay all the money he owed.
Mama, is 100 denarii a lot of money?
That's the thing, Gav. Compared to the 10,000 talents that was forgiven him, the 100 denarii is really, really small. Remember how we said a while ago that to pay back 10,000 talents, one would have to work for 150,000 years, right? Well, for someone to pay back 100 denarii during Jesus' time, one would only need to work for 100 days.
What?
So, if we were to look at our own Philippine money today, how much would it look like? 100 denarii would be like 58,000 pesos. It sounds big, right? But it's so small compared to what 10,000 talents would be like today. 10,000 talents today in our money here in the Philippines would be at least 31 billion pesos.
What?
Not million, billion pesos. Imagine that. While the king forgave this slave for this huge amount of money, the slave could not forgive his fellow slave for such a small amount.
That's unfair.
Now what's going to happen? Let's find out.
Other fellow slaves heard what this slave had done and reported it to the king. The king summoned the slave and said to him,
"You wicked slave, I forgave you all that debt because you pleaded with me. Should you not also have had mercy on your fellow slave in the same way that I had mercy on you?"
Then the king, moved with anger, sent the slave to be tortured until he has paid all of his debts.
Then Jesus ended his story saying,
"That is what my heavenly Father will do to you if you choose not to forgive your brothers and sisters from your heart."
You know, kids, we also have a king, and he is the king of all kings. Gavin, do you know who that king is?
Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus, who is our God. Jesus, who is also the Son of God. Now, our king loves us so much that he wants us to be with him in his kingdom in heaven. But the problem is, we don't always obey God. We don't always follow him, do we? And that separates us from God and his kingdom. And just like the 10,000 talents that the slave owed the king, we could never pay back the price for us to be able to enter his kingdom. No matter how many good things we do for our whole lives. But here is the good news. Just like the king in the parable, God made a way to set us free from all that we need to pay. He sent his own son, Jesus, to pay the full price so that we can be with him in heaven. Now that is a precious gift. Now, Gavin, how can a gift become yours if I give this to you? How does it become yours?
I just accept it.
Exactly. The only thing we need to do for that gift to be ours is to accept it. Gavin, may I ask you something?
Okay.
Do you know of anyone who might be hard for you to forgive? Maybe because that person keeps doing the same thing or saying the same things that hurt you over and over and over again.
Yeah.
Well, based on our story today, how can you follow Jesus' command to forgive these people again and again and again?
By remembering how much more Jesus loves me and has forgiven me.
That is so true. When we admit that we need forgiving and we accept the forgiveness that Jesus has given us, he will also give us the strength to be able to forgive others. Kids, do you think you also need Jesus' forgiveness? Would you like to receive that wonderful gift that Jesus has given us so that you can also be with him in heaven? If your answer is yes, then join us in putting your hands together. And as I lead you into prayer, just feel free to pray the same thing in your heart, okay? Dear Jesus, thank you for being my King and for paying the full price so that I can be with you in your kingdom someday. I need your forgiveness, Jesus. Thank you for the forgiveness that you have given me. And I invite you, Jesus, to come into my heart and be my Lord and Savior. Lord, help me to forgive others again and again and again. And teach me how to love in the same way that you love us. In Jesus' name, amen. So kids, if you just prayed that prayer with us, then this is the beginning of a wonderful journey with you. You can definitely count on God's Spirit to help you forgive others again and again and again.
And again and again and again and again.
And he will help you to love others in the same way as Jesus loves you. So kids, we have some questions for you, and it would be great if you could spend some time with mommy or daddy or ate or kuya or even yaya and take some time to think about these questions and share with them your answers, okay? So we have four questions. First question is, how many times do you want God to forgive you? Second question, how many times does God want you to forgive others? Third question, is it easy to forgive over and over again? Why or why not? And the last question is there anyone you need to forgive today? Pray that Jesus will help you to forgive them from your heart. So Gavin, would you mind sharing with me?
Okay.
How many times do you want God to forgive you?
Infinity.
Infinity. How many times does God want you to forgive others?
Infinity.
Infinity. Is it easy for you to forgive others?
No, not always, because sometimes they really hurt you and you really don't want to forgive him or her.
Mm-hmm. It can be really hard, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, is there anyone that you need to forgive today?
Not really, but I remember someone.
You remember someone from before?
Yeah.
So you're saying that you've forgiven that person already
today.
Would you mind sharing with us about that time? That time where before you forgave and what it was like for you to forgive?
So before, there's this person, he said some really mean things to me and he said I was braggy and I was really hurt. And I asked God to help me. To help me forgive that person, but on top of it all, I also asked God to help forgive me for my bragginess because I realized that I was also being very braggy.
Wow, that is a powerful realization. Thank you for sharing that, Gavin. So kids, don't forget, spend time with mommy or daddy or ate or kuya or even yaya. And share these questions with them so that we can let God's word grow in our hearts.